Okay, good afternoon. So, at first, I would like to give my sincere thanks to organizers who invited me. So my talk is focused on the committee activity, and in addition to that, I will mention all the activity related to geohazards. So my presentation is almost coupled with the talk of Watanabe-san. So the So at first I want to show you the brief history. Already Watanabe-san introduced a story of the development of the geopark in Japan. So this is just the story of the geopark committee history. So May 2008, the committee established according to the strong request by Watanabe-san and others. So at that time, I was the president of Academic Society, Volcanic Society of Japan, and I was also the professor of the University of Tokyo. So that some authorization or some higher level gathering, the specialists are needed to construct such a geopark committee at that time. So the earliest time, Secretariat located in the Geological Survey of Japan, and after 2015, the Secretariat of the Geopark Committee became the in the Geopark Network. So we have three regular meetings a year, and in January 2016, just after the official program of UNESCO, of geopark, and our committee was certified as an organization related to UNESCO Global Geopark Matters by the National Commission of UNESCO. So, and this year we reconstructed the National Committee of Geopark. So, task of the committee, follow the guideline of UNESCO of Global Geopark. And so most important thing, the evaluation of the Japanese candidate for new aspiring Global Geoparks. And we have to be the window to UNESCO and the GGN through the National Commission. So we will check the dossier and for evaluation or revalidation also. And evaluation and revalidation of national geoparks, this is a little different from the task written in the guideline of UNESCO. But this function is very important, already explained by Dr. Watanabe. So this is national geoparks activity is just background of our the Global Geopark the activity. And the linkage to JGN. JGN is a very important engine of our activity, and our community is strongly related to the network in Japan. And we will give advice to the aspiring geopark area and the follow up of the geopark. So the main point of our activity is to keep quality of the geopark Japan in Japanese geoparks. So this diagram shows the process how to nominate the candidate of Global Geopark in Japan. So here, this is aspiring area for national geopark. So national geoparks and aspiring geoparks became the members of Japan Geological Network, GGC. GGN. So here is N. So this relationship between the geopark committee and network is just like UNESCO heart and Global Geopark Networks. So the after recognition, the Aspire Geopark became the national geopark. So after the experience in several years, this became the candidate for the global geopark, UNESCO global geoparks. So again, our committee recommended by the through the evaluation, examination, and then we recommend that area for global, UNESCO Global Geopark through the National Commission of UNESCO. So dossier examination and from the, for example, every stage we have a dossier examination and presentation for examination. So presentation done in the annual meeting of geoscience in Japan, very big meeting. So and the meeting, so any aspiring geopark have to explain the dossier and show the merit and etc. And we are standing in front of those presentation people, and we raise a hand. So what is the point of your geopark, and what is the management, etc. And after that, we will do the on-site assessment by three evaluators, so including our committee members. So after that, the recognition or recommendation will be done. This is the Japanese system. So before this year, the construction of Japan Geopark Committee consisting of this, so 12 members were involved, so chaired by Professor Oike, who is former president of university at Kyoto University, and two representatives for five academic societies. So this is a group of specialists. So why? So already what Watanabe-san explained. So significance of geopark, scientific significance of geopark should be backed up by the specialist. So this is a big reason. So and when the committee started, so some the authorization by the big name. Professors and some famous specialists that are needed to recognize in national level. So that, for example, Geological Society of Japan, and this is a very big number of members, and Japanese geographers, okay, 3,000, and Seismological Society of Japan, and quarterly research people, and Volcanic Society of Japan, this is my academic society, and so one representative from Geotechnical Consultant Association, and the one from Natural Park Foundation. So, and advisor include, for example, Watanabe-san as UNESCO Geopark Council, and Office of National Commission for UNESCO were involved as advisors of this committee. But this the membership a little bit far from the possible some structure written in the guideline. But already we started we continued this system for 10 years. So and the observer include the representative from the ministries and the national agency, like Cabinet Office for Repair, Cultural Affairs, and Forestry, Land Infrastructure, Transportation, and Tourism, and Meteorological Environmental Agency, etc. So, merit of involving the academic society is shown here first. This is the very nice to do the enlightenment activity of geopark. So this is example we are making doing some public and scientific session and the annual meeting of geoscience, a very big meeting. So this is a good chance to advertise and educate the people not related to the geopark, what is a geopark and so on. And human support is possible. So, for example, some member enter into the geopark as the management academic staff. And the special support from academic side is improving the international significance of geology. And if some new finding may raise the scientific significance of the geopark. So that the involvement was important at the time. So, and this showed some education program. We call this kitchen volcanology. So they some dipping some liquid of shampoo on the morphology, not the real morphology, so morphology of volcano, and put liquid on the top, and then shampoo liquid descended along the valley. So you can expect where, which place was affected, will be affected by the lava flow or debris flow, etc. And also we use Coca-Cola, so to know the mechanism of volcanic eruption, etc. After the experiment, you can eat or you can drink. This is a concept of kitchen volcanology. And the bottom is some summer school conducted by the academic staff of the volcanologist and seismologist. This is an example they held in the Toyamusu Global Geopark. So the attendees learn the young people, high school people, learned about how volcanic eruption occurs and how the volcanic hazard make disaster. But after the program of UNESCO, which restructured the committee like this, so this is the main part of committee, and under here is subcommittee, so for namely inspection and steering subcommittee. So the good function of the previous committee that moved to here. And here is some external evaluators appointed by our committee. And outside, it's observers of ministry and agencies. And here is advisors, and here is some sort of academic forum of geoparks. This is just under the discussion, and this is we expect the right function of IUGS. So, when we accept the dossier, so some the scientific part moved to the review under this forum. This is still under the discussion. So this is a member, present member of the Japan Geopark Committee. So first is a member of National Commission of Geopark, this is Ono from Unzen Global Geopark. And this is your serving person, two specialists including me, and Watanabe-san, another Watanabe, who is recommended by Nature Conservation Group, and she is recommended by the Culture Property Protection Group, and he recommended by the she recommended by the tourism related group, and here is IGCP representative, and he is mayor of this town. He is a representative of UNESCO Global Geoparks in Japan, and Watanabe-san is involved as one of the members. So that, so we fulfill the guideline of UNESCO works. So I am chairman, president of this committee. And under that, so here is a subcommittee. Subcommittee contains the representative of presently 8 academic societies, again, geological society, and geographer, seismology, botanical research, and volcanology, and engineering geology, and geomorphology union, and active board studies. So this is very typical in Japan. So, and in addition to recommended representing person, so those 6 person was selected through the public application. So here Watanabe-san, and here is the person Toigawa, and the right is individual member of GGN, and the other couple here also involved here. So we just started this structure this month. So this is the global geopark work. So the biggest number is China, occupied by China, and the second is Spain, Italy is here, Japan is here. Except China, Japan is third largest group. So our contribution to the global geopark network has become very important. So considering this situation, the activity of Japanese geopark network and the committee become stronger and stronger. So here is a temporal change of global geopark number. Red is the number, total number. So here 2004, and now 2018, the number 140. Number of the global geoparks. So here is China, here is Japan. So the number of UNESCO global geoparks in Japan increased with time. But the a little stable here, and then one was added this time, is a peninsula. And brown indicates the number of national global geopark. So again, this number increases with time, but the rate of increase a little stagnated there. This is, we have a reason for that. So this is just the startup stage, so a little ignoring the quality of the geopark. And the second is a sort of explosion, explosion of some living and on the ground. So someone said this is a Cambodian explosion, etc. And now the stable stage. Stable stage is not so stable, but we consider much about the quality of geopark. So this is the history of our assessment on the National Geopark. So we started in 2008. This is number of applications. It's a green card. Green card, those became the new geopark, National Geopark. This is national. So this number increased. Now we are 46 minus 1 equals 45. So this is the percentage of getting the green card. Green card is acceptance. So when look at the number, so the this number increased recently. So this is because we check carefully the quality of National Geopark, referring to the guideline of the UNESCO Global Geopark. And right hand side, the revalidation. So we start revalidation from 2012. So first time the percentage is not so 100%, and the second the 1 year, next time two and last year we gave 4 yellow cards to national geoparks. So for example, one global geoparks, this is Unzen, I got a yellow card 2016 due to we checked some management system, and we knew the lack of composition among all records, and the staff of specialists was very small, so only one people were employed. But this standard is a little different from national standard. So the standard for global geopark in Japan is higher than the national geoparks. So like that, we want to keep the quality of not only national geopark, but also the global geopark. So last year, we gave 2 yellow cards to Sain Kaigan and also global geopark. So those have the revalidation mission this year. So according to our regulation, so 1 year before the revalidation, we will do internal national revalidation mission. For example, this year, Sain Kaigan and ASO. So last year, the time of revalidation in Nawasaki. So at that time, we mentioned the weakness in Sain Kaigan and ASO Global Geopark. So this is a good system. So getting yellow park, those global geopark won't recover and the response recommended comment, etc. So that this the system works well. So for example, after getting a yellow card, Unzen Volcano, Unzen Global Geopark made great effort to recover the weak point. And then they received the revalidation last year and they get the green card from the global level. So this is history of aspiring global geopark. So application 2008 is 5 and 3 were recommended for aspiring geopark, aspiring UNESCO global geopark. And so here is one pending. One pending is Oki geopark. Oki geopark got 1 year pending due to several reasons. And yeah, and here the one defer is a peninsula. So is peninsula is a sort of depending, but the system completely changed, so that this became the defer category. And so two written red, I'll show you later. So two application we rejected due to some reason I explain later. So this is Oki geopark, the picture. Left hand side is the time of evaluation, first evaluation done by Christine and Ibrahim and myself, taken and very beautiful the outcrop, the western coast of this island. So at that time, so they, in the meeting of EGM in Portugal, they got not yellow card, pending. So at that time, so Meyer, he was president of Oki Geopark Council, and others are very disappointed to hear the news pending from Portugal on the early morning of 2012. But next time, it's okay, no problem. We are very happy. Sorry, I missed the picture of that. Okay, so Japan is a very complicated dynamic system. For example, left show the geometry of here is Japan. So from here, Philippine Sea Plate subducted under the island archipelago of Japan, and from right the Pacific plate subducted, And we consist of four plates. So very complicated. So the, due to this abduction, we have many volcanic eruption, and the some deposit characterized by the deposit scraped by the from the ocean bottom. So that we call this accretional crystal. And so that in this activity, the accretional segment from ocean side form the fundamental structure of Japan. Due to this situation, we have many frequent volcanic eruptions and stirring shock due to the earthquake, which occurred along the this thrust and the, this boundary, and related tsunami attack many times on the ocean side of Japan. So that so geohazard became a serious issue for Japanese geopark community. So our committee put emphasis on the following point. So we are checking strong linkage of geological heritage with ecological cultural heritage. And there are many similarities of geological characteristics to each other. So when you see from outside, so many Japanese geoparks represented by volcanic material or accretional prism. So, so that's our aim is characterizing what is different, which is different from the others. So our task is showing not only international scientific significance, but also difference from each other within Japan. This is very good, very difficult, but important mission. So same thing may occur in Indonesia. So this is one example. This is one example we met. So two proposals for Aspire UNESCO Global Geopark from neighboring two national geoparks. So here is a map of Kyushu Island. Kyushu Island is the southernmost, southwesternmost island. There is a geoparks. This the pink is global UNESCO Global Geoparks, Hunzen and Aso. This is a volcanic areas, and here is Kimpoan and Hiroshima. Again, those two volcanic areas. So yeah, those two geoparks are represented by very active volcanic eruption. Here is Sakurajima, and here is Kirishima. So from outside, probably the characteristics are similar to each other. From a scientific side, completely different. But from the common sense, simple volcanic eruption, very young volcano. So what the difference between the two? So this is a very big issue. So due to the similarity of volcanic characteristics, neighboring, so just the neighboring, and the two volcanic already two volcanic global geoparks and also existed in the Kyushu same island, and so we rejected this these two proposals. And our suggestion is combining two geoparks as a new big aspiring geopark. So we continue the follow-up. So for example, on the function of follow-up is invitation of Guy Martini. So Guy Martini was invited in 2016, soon after our decision. And we asked to show his opinion, and he honestly suggested a substantial schedule to the next step. This was very helpful. But 2 years after this, so still, still preparation is they are doing preparation. So yeah, so they need much conversation among the people, community, and the governmental decision, and they need it. So it takes a long time. So this is the list of volcanic hazard in Japan. So starting from 1991, the Hunzen eruption, 24 people killed. And I speak Hokkaido and Kobe. I speak 6,000 people killed, and the others in Tohoku I speak around 20,000 people were killed due to the earthquake and the tsunami. And the volcanic eruption occurred, about 60 people were killed by the rocks thrown from the crater. And the Kumamoto earthquake 2 years ago killed about 50 people. So due to this circumstance, we have people living in Japan have to consider seriously about the geohazard. As a right-hand side, so the some probability of seismic intensity very strong. For example, red indicates very strong shock is expected within 30 years. So, for example, here is Muroto, here is a peninsula, UNESCO Global Geopark, like that. And another, the headache is volcanic eruption. Volcanic eruption, and this triangle indicates distribution of active volcanoes. So, the Global Geopark and the National Geopark very close to the volcanic center of the active volcanoes. So that earthquake, volcanic eruption are very strong headache for us, but so not leaving a headache as those material. So we have how to consider how to face these issues. So this is example Kumamoto earthquake 2 years ago. So the many swarm of earthquake occurred along the tectonic line, active fault. Here is Aso Global Geopark. Here, this is the location of Kyushu. So the active fault moved due to the many times of earthquake, and big landslide occurred here and destroyed the bridge, the important bridge, and under the debris, one car buried, and one young boy killed, one student killed. This is a shrine collapsed due to the vibration, and the up is the active fault appeared on the ground. So this is not paddy field, the wheat field. So you can see the very beautiful lateral movement of an active fault. So this is light lateral in the geological sense. So this is near Mount Aso, and also Aso is active volcano. So before the event of the earthquake, the volcanic eruption occurred, and soon after the earthquake, again eruption occurred. This is a parking lot of the just in front of the office of Geopark. So, so the. So this is Sendai Forum, Sendai framework related to disaster risk reduction. We call this SFDRR. So this is a very important conference of the United Nations. So the conference aimed at discuss about the expected outcome over the next 15 years. So the substantial reduction of disaster risk and loss, lives and livelihood, etc., is discussed. And the goal is the prevention of a new risk and the reduction of existing risks, etc., etc. So the target of this program is reducing 1,000, 1 million people of affected earthquake, etc., in the next 15 years. So this concept was also involved in sustainable development goals. So this So the priority for action discussed there, the understanding of the disaster risk. The second is strengths of disaster risk governance to manage risk, disaster risk and investing in the resilience and enhancing disaster preparedness for effective and to build back better in recovery, rehabilitation, and reconstruction. So the action is very possible to be considered even in Geopa. Network become very important when we face a national disaster. For example, this is a picture of the eruption of Hiroshima. So 2011, this is a picture of damage and the Kumamoto earthquake. So during the disaster, a network played a very important role to assist the damaged area by sending volunteers and money donation. And also those geopark area, they issued the continuously the information of safety, which road can be passed or who is safe, what part was damaged, etc. So those information is very helpful to everything. So we can stop geohazard, so understanding the past of natural disaster and preparing for future become very important. So in this process, geopark activity is very important. So what is this? So understanding this situation, our committee also insists the importance of countermeasure against natural disaster. So in evaluation revalidation mission, we include the terms related to the measures to natural hazard and the outreach program. So those programs involved in the geopark or not. And also how disaster risk reduction against natural disaster was managed in the territory. When you experienced the disaster in ancient time or a few years, and how recover, how reflect the experience to education or in future, for example. So not leaving the disaster as a disaster. So knowledge learning from the damage is very important to use for future generation as education or guidance during tourism tours, etc. So geopark is an excellent outdoor class for disaster risk reduction. Nature side is very useful to understand the mechanism of natural hazard disaster, and it's important for preparedness. And also area impacted disaster, culture side is very useful to learn vulnerability of people and resilience for next disaster and so on. And geotourism is very important to learn the experience and learn the nature of geohazards. And also, this geotourism is a very important engine to recover from the damage. And the geopark is a very good system, especially in Japan. So geopark consists of many levels of the community, so including the governors of prefecture, governors of township or city, etc. So involvement of those people is very important. So when we need some countermeasure for future city plan and so on, the involvement of those people and the discussion with those people is very, very important. So without this system, so lower level people can't discuss, can't talk with the top level of people. okay. So all this time. So this is one of the example of annual meeting. So since 2010, JGN, this is a network activity. So we hold an annual meeting. So here is the seventh meeting 2 years ago held in East Peninsula. So this year we have the annual meeting in Apoi. So we will invite Nicholas Dors as the keynote speaker of the next annual meeting. So, and also the activity of network, it's the Living Magazine, a Japan magazine, Living in Japanese, and prepared around loadable pamphlet. This is written in Japanese or English, sure. And also our committee our colleague prepares the journal, Japanese journal for geoheritage. And so there are many working groups within the network. So conservation, probably tomorrow we have the result from this conservation working group, and the education group, evaluation and disaster prevention, and international linkage already explained by Watanabe-san. And here is a guide working group. Guide working group agreed several very important key points. So the guide should communicate not only knowledge, but with their story, and talk about the story based on the area and the experience, etc. And talk about not only the area, but also the planet of Earth, etc., etc., etc. So this is very important argument, and this is a good agreement among the community of geopark and geoguides. So this is the cartoon showing the collaboration between our committee and the network. So we are discussing many points. And also we discussed the standards. So this is the last fifth slide. So evaluation standard working group. So what we discussed is UNESCO Global Geoparks Operation Guideline is our umbrella. This is the Bible. But even the existing this umbrella, so substantial assessment is not easy in Japan. So reflecting the complexity of the national situation or so immaturity of national geopark and reflection on circumstances, etc. So that we discuss how to evaluate that according to the UNESCO Global Geopark Guideline. So this is the actual. So, so, okay. So the so why so we insisted the evaluation system in Japan. This is without the experience, the experience as a national geopark for at least a few years, any territory cannot apply to global geopark, UNESCO Global Geopark. So this is the reason we want to keep the quality of National Geopark. So this is a summary. So our network is one of the success example among nations. And it's a trap. So, okay, it's finished.